associated spokesperson.
Thank you, Cho Hong San Suu Kyi. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, Mingla Pa. It's a great honor for me to finally have a face-to-face meeting with Cho Hong San Suu Kyi. It is not the lack of my trying, but simply it didn't happen and they didn't allow. Only at the third time I'm meeting her, and we had a very constructive exchange of views on all spectrums of the issues which Myanmar government and Myanmar people will work together with the international community, including the United Nations. In fact, even though this is the first time, we have been in constant contact through telephone or correspondence, or through my special advisors, particularly Vijay Nambiar. What I saw afar has been confirmed this morning. She is really a strong and dedicated leader of this country for democracy and development and human rights for all. I, like everybody in the world, fully admire her leadership and commitment during the last 2-3 decades for peace and development and human rights of this country, for this region, and for the world. She has been symbol of our hope for human rights for all around the world. I congratulated her on her election as a parliamentarian, and I also commended her decision of yesterday to take oath and become a parliamentarian. I know that it must have been a very difficult decision. Politicians sometimes will continue to have differences on some issues, but real leader demonstrates flexibility for the greater cause of people, the country. And this is what she has done yesterday, and I really admire and respect her decision. I'm sure that she'll play a very constructive and active role as a parliamentarian for the betterment and well-being of this great country. In the course of my meetings with the President Tan Shen and Cho Aung San Suu Kyi and other leaders of this government, I have always emphasized the importance of flexibility and wisdom and compromise when they discuss about all different ideas and options and policies, regardless of what party one represents. The politicians and political leadership, they have to look to the people, be accountable to the people, and always work together for the prosperity and long-term interest of their people. President Tan Shen and Cho Aung San Suu Kyi have walked far. I'm sure that, I'm convinced that they will continue to do, to make progress further still. This is what I expect. Myanmar people and government have embarked on a path of reform and democratization and fuller and participatory democracy. They deserve our support. They deserve support of all international community. United Nations will continue to stand by the people in every step and in any way we can. This is my pledge. The process may be difficult. There are still many challenges. this process should be irreversible. There is no turning point, a turning back. We will have to support their efforts for full of participatory democracy, development, and human rights law. And that's my pledge as a Secretary General of the United Nations, to work with them, work with the President Tan Shen and the Myanmar people for this purpose. And finally, I have invited her to visit the United Nations at a time convenient to her and to the United Nations. And I received a very positive answer from her. And I'm looking forward to continuing my good offices role for peace, development, and human rights of Myanmar. Thank you very much.
Can I ask you, so could you give us some information about her positive answer, sir? When can we expect her to visit the United Nations?
Please ask to Aung San Suu Kyi.
I didn't give a definite date. I would like to go to the United Nations, and I will make every effort to do so, but I can't say when I shall be going.
We will continue to discuss.
And I've got a question for Dr. Mama. What message are you going to convey to the military delegates in your capacity as the parliamentarian?
I think I would rather you confine your questions to those connected with the Secretary General's visit, because we only have time for two or three.
What can other
yesterday, I have conveyed my message to a parliamentary address. This is quite difficult. The decisions the political leaders will make over a few months or over a few years will shape the future of this country for coming many generations. Therefore, you are going through a very important period. It needs courage and leadership and the perseverance and wisdom, flexibility and compromise. While moving toward democratization, you need to have reconciliation among all the people of Myanmar. That will be very important. United Nations will try to help this process of reconciliation in any way we can through a peace-building process.
It's difficult to answer this question in a few short sentences, but I've always said that what is important is that whatever aid comes to Burma, whether development aid or humanitarian aid, should come in such a way that it empowers the people and decreases their dependency on the government. That is the only way in which we can ensure that the democratic process in Burma will go along the right path. And I think the Secretary General understands my concerns.
About your second part, there is a high expectation of international community. As we have seen recently, there's a stream of world leaders coming to Myanmar to discuss and help the future of Myanmar. At the same time, it is important that the Myanmar people would have an opportunity of develop their own country. And that is why I'm going to launch the UN Global Compact, the Myanmar Network, right after this meeting. This is concept, an initiative of the United Nations, where 7,000 world-class business leaders are discussing among themselves how they can promote and help each other good trade, good business opportunities among themselves for world economy. I hope that Myanmar's local business entrepreneurs will have opportunity to fully utilize and interact with international business leaders to widen and deepen their business opportunities for direct foreign investment as well as job creation. Through this interaction, they can strengthen their capacity in terms of good business management and accountability, transparency, and even human rights, labor rules. All these are good principles which UN Global Compact tries to promote. I hope that this will be a good opportunity for them to mutually benefit for economic development.
Shall I say one more question or two more questions? What's your time schedule? One more question. I think you have been putting your hands up for a long time.
Hello, my name is Yang Sala from KLD News and Wires. My question is, as the Secretary General said, one of the key concepts will be first delivery. Do you have any specific idea that you are carrying out this concept of flexibility as a member of Parliament?
We have always believed in flexibility in the political process, not just as now that we are going to be members of Parliament, but we have always believed in flexible throughout the years of our struggle, because that is the only way in which we can achieve our goal without violence. So I do not think flexibility is going to be a new concept for us, that newly acquired because we're going into the National Assembly. It has been part of the political equipment with which we have been working for the last 23 odd years. Okay. I'm afraid I must bring this press conference to an end because I don't want the Secretary General to be late for his other appointments. Thank you very much, and I'm sure you will all look forward, all looking forward to meeting the Secretary General again.
Thank you very much. Thank you.